get loose. So she probably got chased, probably one of the times when she got loose, and was running the neighborhood, she probably either got chased down or, you know, yeah, that's my guess. Boy, is she liking to come in. I think she would just be like, yeah. You could never take this in front of us.
Getting stuff from her new. Nothing chicken. Nothing chicken.
Really?
Yeah. And when we first met, but then after they adopted, he was gone.
Yes, actually it is. This is the lady. So John's one of our volunteers. He comes each Sunday to sit with them, and they get all these extra treats. So I told him, she's going to be going home soon, so
yeah, easy on the treats.
She's getting chicken skin. A little bit of chicken skin. Yeah. Yeah, this is, the bar is pretty high on this one. I'm sorry.
Seriously.
Yeah, how can you compete with that? That's not fair, I guess. I'll dial down on that. I'll dial down on that one. Yep.
So I will tell you that we give them about a cup and a half or something. With a little bit of acid, just to see.
Yeah, she's got to make you
battle here. Not that she's got
it. I think when she's Irish, can't tell me.
So we add way too many tablespoons or two of it. Just add a little water, just makes it
okay.
That's just on the reduction we do.
I didn't do that too bad.
Right, you think about it like, well, maybe not.
Oh,
yes.
Let's get this.
Oh, he's all wound up today, look at him.
Okay.
Okay, wait. Yeah, she won't, and she did eat, she actually did eat this morning when she got here, so if she, so they normally do feed in the morning.
All right.
So that's how.
Come on, come on, Forrest.
So if she does, she's not, like, wanna feed at night, then, if she's not interested in feeding at night, then don't worry about it. If you're gonna feed in the morning, yeah, then she should be good.
Okay.
So I'm going to use what she's done for the day, basically. Yeah, as far as food goes, yes.
Isn't that kind of amazing?
Yes.
I know, when I was writing that the other night, I was like, if any of these things had been, so here, and then I found out from staff afterwards, was that, they had, so the mom and daughters had to be, they had gone through the session of kennels for all of these. They had already been through the session of kennels where she was housed, so they were over in the other part of the shelter looking. And it was because he was, Steve, our guy that was unloading, he was walking by to take her back to her kennel as they were coming back from the second section of kennels. So they were gonna be leaving. Told staff they weren't planning on coming back because it had been 7 weeks and that she'd been missing, and they just figured that, you know, hopefully she'd come home with somebody. And so it was just the timing of it. And he was right there, and they said, oh, Bailey, and the dog stopped in her tracks at the gate. And he's like, no, this dog's name is Snapdragon. I'm like, oh, well, we were here looking for a lost dog. And when she turned around and saw them, she immediately recognized all three of them and just started screaming and carrying on. And oh, she was so good. It's nice.
Yeah, sure is.
And like I said, she was in foster for 2 weeks.
Yeah.
They come during that time.
Yep.
Yeah. When she wasn't in the shelter.
Yep. Yep.
And had she come and had they come through, like, maybe, you know, 2 hours earlier and done the same thing. So they actually walked right past the kennel that she was housed in at the shelter, but because she was here, they didn't look at paperwork.
Of course.
Well, and then the shelter new staff showed them the picture of what she looked like. She had wounds all over her face. So even if they had seen her picture online, they might not have recognized her. She really was just a hot mess. So
there you go.
Yeah, it was really nice that everything ended up the way that it did. So they checked her yesterday. They got back. She's had a little bit of a cough this morning. It could just be allergies. So I'm expecting the same. Maybe we'll try something else. Did I give you one of these just now, right? Because you had mine. Oh, okay. So, I'm going to go over the other stuff first. This is just what you signed, so you have a copy of it.
Okay.
This is her, up to this point, this is her medical. Well, this is her kennel card. They sent me two sets for some reason, so I'm just going to send you a call. Thank you. Usually I just send on the medical and behavioral, but so this is her medical, which really so far all it is just when she arrived on March 2nd. It's just her intake, vaccinations, and microchipping. So she did get a kennel call vaccine, but it's kind of the equivalent of the 3-7-2-4. It either works or doesn't. It can't cover all the strains. So she did have that, but it's still very high. So she's had all of that, okay? As we talked about, she still needs to be spayed. So if you guys decide that you're going to keep her, then you're going to set up a stay appointment with PACC. And you'll bring her, and they'll tell you, you'll get an email confirmation after you've scheduled it, but it'll give you all the details. But basically, the day that you're bringing her in, you drop her off between 7 and 8, for everything you need for. So she goes home that day. And then they'll give you all the contact information and stuff like that.
All right.
And then it's on the last page. This one's going to require a little bit more, so I'm going to go over that last. So you're more likely to retain this. That's okay. Oh, yeah, no, I'm sending you home with it. So this was just her behavioral stuff. When
when she first arrived, she was so overweight that she was passed out, like we talked about yesterday. She did go into, they did give her the papers on the 8th, so just a couple days ago. She was initially, she was very reactive, so they go into the play yard. Before they do that, there's what's called a catch pen, so it's like a smaller fenced-in area that has a gate to go into. You close that gate, and then another gate to go into the yard. So their evaluation starts in the catch pen to see how they act with the barrier between them and the other dogs. Because sometimes if a dog has a really bad reaction, they'll choose to muzzle the dog, or if it's really over the top, they may just decide not to do it at all to keep everybody safe. So she was reactive. It said in the catch pen, she had a loose body with a low wagging tail. She appropriately tolerated the other dogs to the fence. In the yard, she was so dogs that was playing, so she would like run away from them. She paced around the yard the whole time she was there. I'm not really sure why they said she was very reactive, because in here they don't talk about her being very reactive. Barrier. So when there's a fence, basically. Yeah, when there's fencing between. You ever seen the videos online where there's two dogs going at it and there's a gate between them, and then the gate opens and the dogs are fine, and then the gate closes and they start fighting again? That's a wonderful example of barrier reactivity. So sometimes you see it in the shelter, sometimes you see it out in public because of fencing. So yeah, there's a lot of ways that they can have that. But just that she's nothing, just that she's, they said their observations, she's friendly, people oriented. They said jumping, tripping hazard, but I think it's really more because she's like, she's always right there with her. She likes to be right by her side. And she can be a little stop and go when she walks, because she's, it's nervous. I think whoever had her before, I think she was probably like, just a backyard dog. She went into the backyard, and she was in the house, and I don't think that she had a lot of experience walking on the leash.
Okay.
Because everything out in the big world is a little scary. So some confidence really would talk about it. Yeah. I'm going to call them in a little bit.
Debbie.
She remembered all on her own. I didn't help at all.
I heard you. Debbie. You know what? I was thinking somebody when I used to work in Canyon Ranch, I was thinking you reminded me of somebody there too. So I was thinking, now I can't remember her name. Hi.
How you doing?
All right.
My mom was married to her dad.
Oh, holy cow.
Hi, Debbie.
That makes me feel so good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
That's good.
And desperate.
Oh.
And after you went further, she said, but you were, I often, you were coming down the steps, or with somebody who come down the steps, and I was with my grandkids and just over here. Yeah.
How was his?
He's doing well, he's still doing a horse. Did they sell the house that was way out west?
Oh, yeah, that's, they sold that a long time ago. So I have a lady that, I don't know, somebody, some that has her, gave her my, and she's been more than I would.
Oh, okay.
But for whatever reason, so this is what about Greg? I think that she's here.
Is it?
I want to find out. Yeah. Who do I have her
to
ask about?
Okay. You're both having this.
I think